What's up everybody, King Louis here with another Mortar tier list video. In the past, I made several tier lists for dueling, and I thought it is time to make one for Frontline and Invasion, since these are the two most popular game modes and people keep asking for it. The goal of this list is to assess the pub stomping potential of each weapon. Of course, everyone has their own favorite weapon that they'll do best with. This list, however, is an attempt to classify the strength of each weapon according to objective criteria. These are for the most part: high damage is obviously better than low damage, swing manipulation reliant weapons are better than feint or more feint reliant weapons, simply because feinting and punishing the feint takes more time than dragging or excelling an opponent. Swing manipulation reliant weapons also allow you to riposte more and thus play faster. Long weapons are better than short weapons. They give more flexibility when switching targets and have other obvious advantages. Lower point cost only matters if that means that you can equip Bloodlust combined with a reasonable amount of armor. Bloodlust in general is a huge pub stomping perk as it lets good players fight hordes of enemies at once. It is confirmed that the perk will get nerfed in one of the upcoming updates, which is good for the game, but probably some time away. And lastly, Cleave is better than Hitstop as it allows to deal damage to multiple opponents at once. I divided this tier list into 6 categories that reach from amazing to absolutely terrible. Other than in my previous dueling weapon tier lists, I did not sort the weapons within a category. Note that if you're a good player, you can do well with any weapon, so don't feel committed to pick only S tier and A tier weapons in your upcoming pubs. The two-handed spear is B tier. I don't think stab dominant weapons are top tier right now. Yes, you can run around and stab people in the back, but opponents that are aware of you usually take quite a bit of time to kill. The Evening Star, a top tier dueling weapon, is also B tier in Frontline and Invasion games. It doesn't have Cleave, which is a pretty substantial drawback in big chaotic team modes. The Evening Star is also rather short and weak against low armored opponents. The consistent two-shot and top-notch swing manipulation are nice, but there are better weapons to kill opponents fast. The Training Sword is obviously F tier. The one-handed axe is C tier. The longsword is B tier. It has rather low damage and reach, but good feints and good swing manipulation. Next we have the battle axe. I was tempted to put the battle axe into S tier, but I think it's A tier. It has good swing manipulation and 2 hit to kill potential against tier 3 armor with 1 head strike and 1 body strike. A main reason, however, why I value the battle axe so high is because it only costs 15 points, which allows you to equip Bloodlust plus a decent amount of armor. The quarterstaff is F tier. The poleaxe is A tier, probably somewhere on the lower end of A tier though. It is a very well-rounded and versatile weapon. Its main trademark is probably the one-frame excels in alt mode. The dagger is F tier, nice for role-playing as an assassin, but not ideal for carrying games. The rapier is D tier, fun to use, but deals very low damage to armored opponents. The War Axe is the first S tier weapon on this list. It has consistent 2 hit to kill against tier 3 chest in combination with the ability to cleave and combo. The War Axe is with 15 points also cheap enough to equip it with Bloodlust and a reasonable amount of armor. Its only drawback is its low range, but the advantages make easily up for that. The Arming Sword is D tier. The Arming Sword is a good example of a stab dominant weapon that is good for duels but not very good in Frontline and Invasion. The average time it takes to kill an opponent is simply too long. The Maul is S tier. The average skill level in Frontline and Invasion games is pretty low. People too often let opponents run up close to them for free, and people also don't chamber enough. That, in combination with the one-shot potential against tier 3 helmet, makes the Maul an S tier Frontline and Invasion weapon. Obviously, the better you are at aiming, the better the weapon gets. The pub stomping potential is certainly very high. The one-handed spear is only C tier, mostly due to the lack of combo potential. The heavy hand axe is also C tier. The greatsword, one of the best dueling weapons, is A tier in Frontline and Invasion games. It has top tier swing manipulation, great feints, and decent range. The greatsword is a very good pub stomping weapon, only outclassed by weapons that deal more damage. The bastard sword is C tier, And what I said about the Arming Sword also applies here. The Morphane mix-up playstyle is not very good for killing players fast. Loot, Mallet and Blacksmith Hammer are F tier. The Pole Hammer is B tier. It has super good range and consistent 2-shot against tier 3 armor, but no cleave, no combo, rather slow and below average swing manipulation for a 2-hander. The Messer is A tier, a very strong weapon that only costs 15 points and lets you equip Bloodlust with full tier 2 or 2-3-2 armor. The Mace is B tier. It is the only 1-hander that can kill tier 3 chest with 2 strikes, but it is very slow, short and has hit stop. The Halberd is A tier. Good reach, good damage, good swing manipulation. The Aztok is B tier on my list. I think the Aztok is currently the best stab dominant weapon in the game due to its super fast stab combo windup. One could probably argue to value it higher than B tier. Let's say it's the best pup stomping weapon in B tier. The Executioner Sword is S tier. It 2-shots tier 3 chest, has decent range and it can cleave. The weapon also deals massive damage to low armored opponents and its drag axial mix-up is exceptionally strong. The Executioner Sword's only drawback is the fact that it cannot combo, which is honestly not that big of a deal. The Falchion is D tier. The Partisan is C tier. The main reason the Partisan is inferior to the Spear and Aztok is that its stab windup and stab combo windups are very slow. The Cleaver is D tier. The Zweihänder is A tier. After its recent buffs, the Zweihänder is a top tier weapon again. It has now the longest release time out of all weapons in the game, which makes its swing manipulation exceptional. It also has very good range, probably one of the better A tier weapons. The Warhammer is C tier. Low range, hit stop and bad swing manipulation. The Shortsword is F tier. For a 1-point weapon, the Shortsword is not bad, but it definitely is not suited to carry pup games. The Bardish is A tier, even after its recent nerfs. The weapon lost its 2-shot potential against tier 3 armor with 1 head strike and 1 body strike. It is still a very good weapon in frontline and invasion however. The Bardish has good range, good swing manipulation and decent damage. The Felx is also A tier. It can 2-shot tier 3 armor with 1 body and 1 head strike and cuts through light armor like a hot knife through butter. The Felx has very floaty drags that catch most non-veteran players off guard. Last but not least we have the Billhook. I put the Billhook into C tier, mainly because of its low strike damage. It is probably one of the better C tier weapons however. Alright guys, that's it for this pup stomping weapon tier list. Let me know in the comments section what you think of this ranking and which one of your favorite weapons I severely underrated. If you enjoyed this video, then please leave a like and consider subscribing to this channel. As always, thank you all for watching and see you soon.